Hello, today I'm gonna talk about crude oil refining. The term crude oil refinable can be associated with the cooking process. The aim of the process is simply to extract numerous useful products that exist in the black viscous matter, refers to crude oil. In its natural state, crude oil is useless. However, once it becomes one of the most sought-after commodities on Earth. The process of refining crude oil is as simple as heating the black mass in a column and at different temperatures. At each temperature level, a product is extracted. In the end, products such as jet fuel, oil, diesel are produced. The first stage of refining is called separation. Since crude oil exists in various chemical molecules, different size and weight, it must be heated sufficiently so that the molecules become detachable. These molecules have different boiling point, so the first task of the refiner is to separate these molecules from each other and make them independent through subjecting them into high temperatures. During separation, refiners heat the crude oil inside a 60-meter distillation column at high temperature sufficient to break down the molecules. As I mentioned in the second slide, after heating, the gas molecules, which have a boiling point of between 30 and 80 degrees Celsius, rise to the top. The gas is then collected in metallic containers ready for distribution. Second, gasoline reaches boiling point at a temperature between 88 and 193 degrees Celsius. Gasoline, which is used in fueling automobiles, is collected in the second topmost tray. The third molecule, heavy naphtha, has the boiling point of between 88 and 125 degrees. Naphtha is a flammable material used as fuels in industrial plants. Fourth, kerosene reaches its boiling point at between 193 and 271 degrees Celsius. Kerosene is commonly used in industrial for fuel jets. Fifth, diesel oil reaches boiling point at between 271 and 321 degrees Celsius. Diesel is used as a fuel for vehicles and industrial equipment. Six, the thicker lubrication has a boiling point of between 321 and 425 degrees Celsius, and it is sinful of to be used as lubricants. Lastly, fuel oil, which has a boiling point of between 510 and 564 degrees Celsius, are collected near the bottom of the column, while tar or bitumen is the last to be collected. Because it has the highest boiling point over 565 degrees Celsius. The second stage is the conversion. There are still many significant levels of hydrocarbon molecules that remain in the residual mass of the crude oil. Therefore, refiners subject the residual mass to a second stage of heating. The aim of the refiner during the conversion stage is to break the residual mass to release the remaining molecules. During the conversion stage, refiners use a catalyst in order to speed up the separation process. As I mentioned in the third slide, during the conversion process, 75% of the residual mass is converted to petroleum products described in the separation stage. To increase the output, the refiners can add hydrogen gas into the column to remove excess carbon from the residual and make it more pure. However, the more the process and catalyst used, the more expensive the process becomes. Lastly, refiners need to clean the fuels that are produced during the separation and conversion stages. Treating refers to the removal of those corrosive substances from the crude oil products. These molecules are harmful because they cause air pollution and damage the industry equipment. One of the main pollution elements in the oil is sulfur. Sulfur leads to the formation of acid rain. Therefore, some countries have stringent standards of sulfur emissions. During the treating process, refiners heat the products at temperature of about 370 degrees Celsius and at a pressure of 60 bar. During this stage, the manufacturers mix hydrogen with sulfur and form hydrogen sulfide, an industrial gas. Products such as kerosene, butane contains mercaptans, a chemical compound that renders them impure. Refiners remove the impurities by washing the products with sodium hydroxide. The process referred to as sweetening. Carbuyl must undergo the treatment process to remove impurities and increase their octane ratings. Octane ratings is the measure of the fuel suitability to internal combustion engines. To prevent detonation, the fuel must have an optimal octane rating of between 95 and 98. So the refiners use the catalytic reforming process to improve the octane ratings of fuel. Platinum is the key catalyst in the process of catalytic reformings. In addition, refiners can use the process of alkylation. Alkylation is the process through which the number of carbon atoms in fuel molecules increase. After the final refining process, the crude oil products are ready for use. As I mentioned in the last slide, each crude oil products have specific uses. For example, LPG is the commonly served as an automotive fuel. In addition, household can use LPG for cooking and heating purposes. Heating oil is used primarily to provide warmth in building, especially during wintry conditions. So lastly, tar or bitumen is the key materials used in road constructions. Thanks for watching.